Copa Airlines is probably the best airline you have not heard of. It's one of the leading airlines in Latin America, and I'm joined with the CEO, Pedro Helbron. So when I take a look at your airline, you know, usually when we talk about airliners, it's all negative. It's labor problems, it's problems with fuel, it's just problems. I look at Copa and your demand is up, your traffic is up, you're buying new planes. You know, how have you done this? How have you figured this out?
Okay, so I should say first that the industry is doing better overall, but we've been positive for a long time. And we've been, you know, for many years focused on one business model, never diverting from it, which is a hub we call Hub of the Americas, based in Panama, connecting a number of cities throughout Latin America that need a hub. Cities that are too small for non-stop service. That's what we do. We do it very well, and we keep on adding service and adding airplanes and building that same business model.
So you're going to the people in Latin America, to those underserved cities, you're bringing them over to Panama, then you're bringing them up to other cities like Las Vegas, Boston. You've started adding a lot of American cities.
Definitely. In most cases, we're the only or the better option to Latin America. Boston will be our 8th U.S. city now in July, and we'll be the only Latin American airline, the only direct flight from Boston to Latin America, similar to when we opened Las Vegas over a year ago and a number of other destinations. So we try to find unique markets that are not well served.
I also noticed that you're buying new airplanes. Is that one of the draws to your company? Is that your customers can get on a new plane?
Definitely. We've been adding on average around 10 new Boeing 737-800s per year. Our fleet age averages around 5 years. The new aircraft come with a Boeing Sky interior, seat back, in-flight entertainment, and they're very, very modern and comfortable. So yes, that's an attraction.
You know, there has been a lot of talk about the economy in Latin America, how it's been so strong and growing. Is that also what's helped you with your clientele?
Definitely. Latin America as a whole is growing above 3% consistently, GDP growth. There's a number of people, I mean millions, entering the middle class every year. The middle class in Latin America is approaching 200 million people. And Panama in particular, which is our home base, has been growing in double digits for the past 3-4 years. Panama has become a very successful business and logistics hub for Latin America, and that obviously helps us quite a bit.
Now, how do you address some of the problems that plague other airlines? Labor problems, fuel problems, how do you get past that?
Well, okay, fuel, it's something we cannot control. So what we do is we focus on the things we can control and we can do well. And it doesn't matter if it's a boom year or a crisis year, we're very consistent in delivering very, very low, very efficient unit cost, a very consistent and high standard product and service. And we have good labor relations, so we try to do what we can control in the best possible way and do it consistently.
All right, so you've got Boston coming up. You know, are you choosing your American cities by what your customers are demanding, the places that they want to go the most?
It's a combination, and our customers come from throughout America, Latin America, North America. We serve around 65 cities throughout the Americas. And in terms of Latin American hubs, we have the most complete and extensive hub. So yes, we look at that, but we also look at cities that need our service, cities that are not well served. Boston is a good example. We'll be the only flight from Latin America to Boston.
All right, well, there you have it. They are going after the underserved, and so by doing so, it's making Copa Airlines strong. That's CEO Pedro Helbron, and I'm Deborah Borchardt with The Street.